Dreamland is a counter pick. The rest of the bottom are starters.
All right. So, yeah, we got Lasagna Cat against Blaze at 420. Oh shit. Oh man.
Alright. Throwback to freshman year.
Yeah, down tilt, so strong. Some well placed eggs. Quick first stock. Oh. We got up air combos.
Alright, one of these Yoshis is black. Let's figure out which one it is.
Oh, not AMSA.
This touchpad is so sensitive.
Ooh, that was a nice drop through up there. Shit, we got more eggs. Not quite.
All right, four stock. You won't.
Four stock. These sick gims.
All right.
Oh no!
My God, what is going on here?
What is this game?
The set knockback.
Yoshi
is so overpowered. Like, it's not fair that a character has set knockback moves.
Shit.
Okay, John finally takes one.
Yep.
This game has been janky.
We cannot get around those down tilts. Strong. Oh,
oh
no,
no!
Not again!
Okay. John manages to survive that one. Nice fastball to ledge by Kim.
Yeah. Shield grab, not Yoshi's strongest option. Oh, double nair. Oh!
Ah!
Intended mechanics.
Nicely timed get up attack using the invincibility to dodge the down tilt there.
Ooh.
Waits and shield. Just lets the egg go by. Caleb probably could have used that opportunity.
Oh,
to
these
get
are
a grab.
Good. These are good Yoshi combos right now.
Caleb leveled up after not playing for like a month.
Let's go. Oh, okay.
All right.
We got Fox things. Oh.
All right.
A very strong performance by.
Takes game one.
Yeah.
Can you turn the volume down a bit?
I can do it over here. I can do it over here. Oh, okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, yeah, you got to buy. All right. So
game two. Let's see. Where do you think they're going to... Oh, John's going Peach. Okay.
Okay.
Makes sense.
Yeah. can't get gimped quite as easily with the down tilts.
Probably see Dreamland.
Yeah. I don't really know.
Two bands.
What up? You want to play?
Winner bands two, loser picks.
Nah, okay.
Wait, did Leslie enter?
Nah, Leslie didn't want to enter. She's doing homework.
Oh. Nerd.
Yeah, nerd doing homework while we play video games.
Right?
Yeah.
Get your priorities straight. Come on.
Seriously.
Which are you going to use later on in your life? Homework or Melee?
Yeah.
PM.
Oh, Project
FOD. Interesting.
Oh. Yeah, I definitely get this. Peach is super good on FOD with all those down smash on platforms.
Yeah. That makes sense. Yoshi's pretty tall.
Good use of double jump armor right there to get back to
Caleb's
the neutral.
Really good at taking advantage of that.
Nice thing about Yoshi and PM is he can actually jump out of shield.
Your match will be in about 10 minutes.
Okay.
Oh, when you call out a match, you can hover over it and click the play button. And it'll say that you've started it. It makes it a little bit easier to keep track of what's going on.
Mike and Swiggity are playing. Dave might end up getting a bye if Adon doesn't come. That's fine. That's probably how the game would have gone anyway.
Alright, this game is going much more slowly. Peach. Bad DI on the dash attack, that'll do it. FOD with the very short horizontal blast zones.
Pretty even game, honestly. Oh, that's...
Oh, that
gets hit out of the double jump.
Both players are playing pretty carefully here.
Yeah.
Picking their aerials.
Good job not crouch canceling that. Alright. Oh, good change of direction with that.
Yeah.
dodge that attack with it.
I'm not sure if his Nair would have been able to work. Mm-hmm. Probably a good call. Definitely a safer option there.
Yep.
Ooh,
ooh, that was
I like
sick.
That.
Okay.
Yeah. We had 8 combos.
Caleb, the American sniper, I guess.
Nice. Yeah, no.
Threw
easy.
That egg a little bit
yep.
too.
Clean edge guard from the Sonya Cat. Knowing when he had to do and nothing more.
Disagree with the way Caleb edge guarded there, but.
Yeah, that was a little scary.
I don't really know what options Yoshi would have. Back air, I guess,
mm-hmm.
you could go off stage with.
Ooh.
Whoa, that was really good.
That was a lot of shield pressure. But you can't shield poke Yoshi, so.
Yeah. Crouch cancel the first hit of down smash mm-hmm. so that you can shield. I honestly don't know if I've ever seen that before.
Yeah. Ooh.
Oh, that
good,
was.
Good dodge.
Dodges both of them.
2-0? All right. Good stuff.
All right. 1-1.
You play me.
Caleb's going to
yeah.
need to do some adapting
easy
here. Although he did really just kind of lose his double jumps pretty early and died at low percent.
These are long games going on right now.
It's not too
bad. Oh, sweet. It's 1-1, right?
Oh, yeah. Good call. Put it on into
what's
losers.
Up? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Chris,
the
go.
Caleb did really good the first game. Yeah.
Go ahead and put it on into losers, and all then right. just call out the next match.
What do I say? Do I just put Prone as winner?
Just put Adon as -1.
Okay. Oh, now it's... Okay. Wait, how did Mike end up in here?
I don't know.
Fuck.
You could play against Mike Prime if you want, though.
Who, what?
You play yeah. against Mike Prime.
Dave might get 2 passes.
That's fine.
Whatever.
Automatic top 8 for Dave.
Yeah. Yep, fucked up not kicking out Mike. We can give him a second. Maybe Mike will show up in time.
We can wait until the next round of bracket, but you need to go play Mike Prime so that we can get things yep. on underway. All right. So, Lasagna Cat, slight lead here, but 1 forward smash might be able to do it. WarioWare has low blast zones. Okay, Nair will do it. 69, let's go. Ooh, I disagree with that rule there. He had a lot of options. Could have nared out of shield, grabbed. Oh, that air dodge was so close. Up tilt. Oh, was that a stitch face? Wave dash. Oh. That was sad. Okay, great stock by Caleb. Bringing it back here. John likes those rolls up onto stage. Nice flow. Damn it, Caleb, edge guard. You can't just throw eggs out there against Peach. Oh, nice roll away. Oh, that Nair reach is so low. Okay, John with a pretty big advantage here. Still doable for Caleb. Blaze at 420. 1 Nair, up air. Up tilt, I guess. That was the... How did that even hit? Caleb going for these Nairs at low percent, but there's not enough hit lag to really stop John, so he can just Nair back. Alright. Lasagna Cat takes it 2-1. Good set to both players. Wait. Chris never put me in bracket. Okay, I'm just going to take Miso's spot because he's not here. Chris didn't put me in bracket, so I'm just going to take Mike's spot.
Wait, no. Take a Don spot.
We already put a Don into losers. And Mike is seed 2, which is more accurate for me anyway. So,
Mike says he's coming late, though. He's going to be here.
He said he'd be here at, 8. I don't think we should wait.
That's not fair. Okay, yeah. And go ahead.
All right. Let's get Skerzo versus Pablo on stream. Skerzo versus Pablo on stream.
Unless you get somebody on that corner set.
Yeah, I'm about to. What?
I assume that's what you're calling for corner setup?
Yeah.
I'll go this way.
Hey, hi, what's up? I'm Asura. I guess I'm commentating for a hot minute here. Let's see what is up. Skerzo versus Pablo. What? No, I'm here alone. I will momentarily be joined on the mic by Jay. So Skerzo Pablo should be a pretty good matchup, honestly. Pablo, a pretty underrated player. Skerzo, kind of just the best at Melee. It's a little bit unfair to the rest of us, really. But PM's a different game, so let's see how this goes. Check, 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 check.
You guys know striking? 1, 2, 1. Yeah.
Yeah, they got this.
Too many players.
It's 1, 2, 1. That's the same as it is in Melee. Literally the same
you
start.
You don't get two in Melee? Is that enough? I thought you get one first.
No, because there are four, or five. And then there's the six that's the counter pick.
All right, never mind.
Yeah, right?
I stand corrected.
Am I right? I'm pretty sure I'm right.
I don't know. I don't play that game.
Trust me, I know.
All right, I believe you.
So, Marth Sheik, we should probably change this to the right things.
Berg versus Skerzo? Believe it or not, I think this matchup.
Pablo.
Believe it or not, I think this matchup is a little bit better for Sheik in this game.
Oh, really?
She's got a little bit easier time, getting things started in this game.
Yeah.
Her grab's not nearly as good as it is in Melee, but she has F smash for starting combos, and she can actually end combos with Up B. Up B is a really strong finisher in this game.
Really? Is a finisher?
And she has attack is, and she can combo into the tipper of her up smash, and it kills like Fox. Like Melee Fox.
Interesting.
So, there's a lot of hidden gems on Sheik that people don't take advantage of.
Yeah, it seems like she's a pretty underplayed character, I should say, in this game. Just overall.
In the PM meta, she's about, I think she's round number 5 or 6. The best character in the game, so she's pretty still really good.
Damn, yeah.
All right, she's I was gonna say he was firmly in Marth percent, couldn't finish her.
I don't know why the Sheik logo thing isn't updating, so I'm sorry, Pablo. You're gonna show up on stream as
he's a Yoshi
playing
name.
A Yoshi. Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
Ooh, good fair. Pablo's doing really good. He is doing really good. Like I said.
Pablo? Yeah, dude, he's legit. He's a very underrated player. I think he's got a lot of potential.
He's improved a lot since started playing against him. He's gotten better. The Sheiks at our scene have gotten a lot better in a short amount of time.
Yeah, which is so nice, honestly. Yeah. Like, good Sheik play is actually really fun to watch.
Yeah, they're ninjas.
Yeah, but like bad Sheiks are so lame. Oh, I see what you mean about the finisher now.
Yeah, definitely stronger. That was what, 80?
Yeah. So does Marth have any new tools to play with Sheik here, or is it just
Marth's kit has only gotten buffs, but they're really subtle, and you have to know PM to abuse them. B reverse side here. B, super sick. It's like, imagine Ganon's float, but with a hitbox. Because I can, you know how as Ganon you can switch directions?
Yeah.
Well, now he can do that, but he gets the hitbox, and it's like got less lag than Ganon's
so
float.
So you just keep switching directions with the side B?
You can. It's actually really interesting if you use it at ledge. You can B reverse side B and put a hitbox out, and then float back and re-grab ledge.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's really
sick.
That's
really interesting, actually.
Brings it. Okay, we've got a game on our hands. Somehow got a gimp, I think.
Yeah. Unfortunate, but
he's got a good juggle going. I haven't paid much attention to like the how these guys are getting their combo started. Good grab there. Ooh. Oh wow. Think he could have bared there? Oh, gets the reverse up B. That was
good
very close.
Good shit to Skerzo with that comeback, though.
I think that was a great game.
That would have been a pretty big upset if Pablo took that first game, I'm going to be honest.
Yeah. Well, he did well. I think he can do it. I mean, that was really close.
Oh, absolutely. They were, I mean, pretty much dead even for most of that game. I mean, Pablo had a stock lead.
Pablo had
the
lead
time,
for a while.
But, I think in terms of, like, gameplay and the combos that they were getting, they seemed very even to me.
Yeah.
This is certainly anyone's set still.
Oh, we have a counter pick. He's thinking. He's thinking. Luigi. I played his Luigi last week in Melee, and I got almost got four stock by it. It was like a three stock, and I think the second game was a little bit better for me. But the first game was rough, so Luigi's good.
You definitely can't just ignore the Luigi. It's definitely true.
Where would you take? Plan.
You have to play bagels for you sake.
I can't even hear game sound out of this. I don't know why I'm bothering. What was that?
You have to play bagels. Where do you take him?
I mean, Wario Land, but I'm never going to get that. I don't know. Luigi's scary in this game to me.
Yeah.
Better ledge dash. 1 in 6 misfires. Like, you can count it and save it.
Yeah.
A down B that functions, like, always good for recovery.
Luigi definitely seems to be a pretty underrated character to me.
I think
I mean,
so, too.
I think they're mid-tier, mid-high tier, maybe.
Luigi in the current meta, like what people think that he is, he's considered low tier, I think.
Really?
Yeah. Like low mid.
That, there's no way. I think he's mid high at least.
With movement like that, I think you can, like the sky's the limit for a character. I mean, definitely better than mid low, in my opinion.
But
I'm up. 2-0 you. Oh, okay. Here, I'm up.
Can you switch off the commentary?
Let me go. All right, Shay is hopping on the mic, and he is being replaced by the one and only Captain Mythic. In just a minute, he
adios, guys.
Score. So honestly, so far, even with the Luigi, this set doesn't look super uneven. I would say that Skerzo definitely has an upper hand now as compared to last game, but this is absolutely still a good chance for Pablo to eke something out here. I don't know about that air dodge. I'm not sure what he was trying to do there. Ooh, that was a big punish he missed.
TTMP versus Lasagna Cat on the corner setup.
Starting losers.
Prown versus Swiggity on that setup.
You're gonna have to call that again, no, I didn't hear you.
Dave. Dave, you're playing Swiggity on that setup. I think that's Noah.
Yeah, you gotta call Noah too.
Noah, are you Swiggity? You're playing Dave.
jeez. Right. What have I missed here? That's unfortunate. Well, 2-0 for Skerzo. And Pablo played well, but is unfortunately put into losers here. It's a nice run. I'd like to see more of what he can do.
You're not playing Pablo. Pablo's playing Blaze at 420.
Oh, and then me.
Yeah. Ben, you're up against Caleb now. Caleb.
Are you down to play that match now?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. You're on stream whenever, preferably soon.
So once again, we have got Pablo.
I'm just going to DQ Adon.
Is he playing Blaze at 420?
Yeah.
So Blaze at 420 played Yoshi,
yeah.
If I recall, right?
Where is he? Oh, Caleb, you're up.
And this is still not updating.
You have to. Oh, click X.
It was on Sheik. What the? Oh God, what have I done?
All right, Leslie.
Control Z.
How do we open the controller thing? The character thing.
The like character switchy thing.
Oh, like the names?
Yeah.
Yeah. Go to the. You see that folder next to the Internet Explorer thing?
Yoshi.
And on the bottom of the bar.
Yoshi. This.
Yoshi.
This.
Live text editor.
Cool. Thanks.
All right.
Thanks.
All right. Blaze at 420 versus Pablo, Yoshi versus Sheik. I don't really know anything about this matchup. I know Sheik has a chain grab in melee. What? Oh, yeah. This is round one losers. Sheik has the chain grab in melee, but since Sheik's down throw DI was changed, I doubt that's still the case.
What is our tournament name?
Oh. Dreamland isn't the... Yeah. Wait. I thought it was Delfino's. We can double check after this tournament. It doesn't really matter that much.
Alright, no, that's just not changing. Weird.
None of them are working? Your tournament needs a name. Oh.
Yeah, I didn't know what to give that name.
Well then.
Right?
Yeah, I don't know what to do about that.
I guess we'll just deal.
Yeah. Alright, so we can't update scores for some reason.
We can update scores.
Oh, wait.
No, everything works. It's literally just that one thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe if we change this to a Sheik that isn't neutral. Oh, yeah, there's no neutral Sheik in here.
Oh, well, there we go.
Alright. Interesting.
So, that was interesting, yeah.
Seems like the melee data got deleted or something.
Super interesting.
Alright, anyway, on to the game. Pretty even here.
Sheik Yoshi, what is this matchup?
I have no idea.
What is even happening?
I would imagine Yoshi actually has a pretty good matchup here because of Sheik's crouch cancel is terrible.
According to Blaze at 420, Yoshi sucks and this matchup is trash.
Okay.
So I guess we should take that word.
Yeah, so I guess whoever wins is right. Or
yeah. Whoever wins has a worse matchup. I think that's fair.
No, whoever wins has the better matchup. All right.
Yeah, but then we can't play to their ego.
True.
And that's what
okay.
Smash is all about.
Up air's pretty good, if you didn't know.
Oh my god.
He just used like eight
fucking
of them
20
in a row.
Up airs later.
420
maybe
up.
We'll finish this fucking, yeah.
Nice triangle dash.
Nice double jump armor there.
That was a great weight on that recovery.
Yeah.
Not so great there.
Caleb needs to be down smashing here.
Honestly, the forward smash works.
Yeah, well, I was just saying instead of the down tilt, because down tilt has set knockback, there's no real reason to use it at the ledge under, like, 60. Or
is it 420 asks us to call him Blastoise? So I'm just going to change his tag here.
All right. Unfortunately, we can't change it in the bracket.
That's cool. No bow.
Caleb's surviving to very high percent here.
Yeah, he's actually doing a great job with this stock.
I was about to say, at this point, he doesn't really have any setups into combos, but...
Did not have that jump, but...
Yeah. I think his DI on the down throw is not good enough.
Those needles were killer just now.
They rack up so much damage, and especially for Sheik at low percent, that damage is crucial, because she just loses to crouch cancel outright.
Yeah.
That's like her only weakness, really. Well, not her only weakness, but one of her main ones.
Mm. Obviously, see, he down smashes and it doesn't work.
Well, he should have hit with it then. Whose fault is that?
I bet a side smash would have hit.
You're a side smash.
Yeah, Blastoise is doing pretty well for himself right now.
Yeah.
But he's really got a...
It's still pretty even.
I mean, one stock to two. This is definitely a game he can come back from. He's
yeah.
shown that he can get some pretty good combos.
A stock is not a lead, as a wise man who I don't remember the name of once said. Probably Scar.
It sounds like something Scar, maybe Blur would say.
True.
Blur would make up some sort of like wise shit like that.
Hello. Back air? Back air? Up tilt? Oh, you won't. Wombo con- Oh.
Wombo con- Where you at? Get fucked.
Oh, that needle almost hit. Oh, the down air! Oh, that was very
down
nice.
Smash, is that going to finish it? No, he's what? Got that. What? No.
All right, Yoshi's
he's got
down.
Nothing. That is 1-0 up for Pablo, and I'm just going to go ahead and change his tag back to Blaze at 420 now.
Yeah.
I think he lost his title as Blastoise.
Honestly, though, do you think he deserves Blaze at 420 at this point?
It's questionable, man. I got to be honest. That's a big tag to hold up. And with results like this, you got to ask yourself, do you deserve it?
Yeah. Speaking of which, when do you think Flunk Day is going to be?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Good call, good call. The safe one, of course.
Yeah, always the safe bet. Honestly, though, I would imagine the first Monday of May.
First Monday of May. When is that, like May 2nd?
Something like that, yeah.
Wait, a Monday, you think? Whoa.
I always want it to be a Monday.
Why?
I would prefer a Wednesday.
Wednesday would be good. Friday would be ideal, but they're not going to do that.
No.
People would...
I'm honestly fine with it.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter to me because my schedule is basically the same every day.
I have got... Yeah.
For those viewers who don't go to Knox, Flunk Day doesn't actually exist, sorry.
First of all, why are you watching this?
Also, yeah, true. For the Project M professional scouts watching this video, wait until Grand Finals.
Also, Mythic does not have a sponsor if you are looking.
Best Roy at Knox College. Arguably the best Blue Roy, whose tag starts with the word captain in Illinois.
Oddly specific, but okay. Is there a better Blue Roy in Illinois?
I don't know if there's another Blue Roy in Illinois.
There you go. Settled.
Although, honestly, according to Che, I might just be the best Roy in Illinois. So, who knows?
You know... I feel like Yoshi isn't that bad of a character, and it's just being used pretty badly right now. We're just not seeing a great Yoshi.
Yoshi has a lot of really complicated stuff that you need to know before he's really good.
Yeah.
I'll fight you right here, right now.
You know,
the man has a disability. You can't just go about talking shit like that. Come on.
That's true.
Have some decency.
I have a condition.
I have a condition. It's called playing Yoshi.
Pick a better character.
I can't.
Why not?
Then play your character better. I don't know what to tell you, man. Not like your character's bad.
I play Falco in Melee, and you're going to tell me your character's bad?
Where am I?
Uh-oh. Adrian, can you come enter your password? It's right. Shut off.
So Blazer 420 still down a stock.
Also, did you finish your match? No, it wasn't you playing. Guys, what was the result over there? John!
This is a quick reminder to those of you who are watching this VOD right now. When you finish your matches, you really need to report the score to the TO. I feel like this is kind of a basic thing.
Who got DQ'd?
If you're watching this, you probably care enough about this game that you do that anyway, but like...
Are you insulting me again?
Wait,
did
you not get entered?
I gotta be real.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Alright, two stocks apiece.
2-1.
This is definitely a game that Blaze at 420
TTMP.
Can come back from.
What was your result?
I won, because I'm a baller.
See, here's the thing. A lot of this game is about mentality. And if you genuinely believe that you're not going to win the game, then you're not going to win the game.
No, you're playing Lasagna Cat versus Yo on this setup.
I don't know about down B as shield pressure.
Right.
I don't know much about Yoshi. But
it's a sick move.
I feel like doing the one thing against shield is probably not that good.
Alright, I'm gonna go to the bathroom.
Alright. Yes, I'm here by myself.
Nah, dude.
With off mic commentary from the players themselves.
Woo!
That is not a kill.
It's
69%. This is definitely a winnable game. What we've got to see here, though, is some good Yoshi shit. And that's just not what we're getting right now. We're getting what appears to be an easy kill and a victory for Pablo, who pulls it out over Blaze at 420. To continue on in losers. Good shit to Pablo. Always nice to see him succeed here.
I thought somebody was back here.
Yo, TTMP fucked up Lasagna Cat. Logan just was. He went to the bathroom.
Oh.
What?
Hey, Ben. Are you cool playing again? Is Chris playing right now?
Chris, are you playing the match?
Yo, Arturo!
Hey, is Chris playing a match over there?
Is Chris in set?
Yeah.
Cool.
Someone else. Who else is up?
I mean, other than that, it's literally just winter semis.
I can't yell.
Yeah. That's there in the corner.
Pikachu.
Oh yeah, I told Yo to play Pika. Well, he's just playing a different character every week, and I told him why do you never play Pika, and he said good point. Yeah, honestly, I don't want to play against a Squirtle. Pika's really fun.
Better Pokemon.
Wait.
Play some friendlies on stream.
Yeah, Chris isn't set right now. Should we just do a winner semi?
Yes. Brackets gonna fall behind. Losers is gonna fall behind, but we can't.
I mean, losers is already behind. Like, versus TTMP is probably going to be the hyper set. Alright guys, we have got a real treat for you coming up on set here, and it is not this bullshit friendly that's about to happen. We have got the one and only Captain Mythic. Playing against the other one and only... Oh shit, what are you doing?
Whoa,
whoa!
What are you doing?
That's gotta be changed to TTMP. And also this is winner semis. TMP is a Zelda.
No, I did the wrong order.
It's only that tape. Why? He plays Zelda. He's actually super legit Zelda, if I may say so myself. Oh. That looks bad. TTMP, this matchup is definitely favorable for Roy, though it's a lot closer than most of the Swordborn matchups for Zelda. So, TTMP is a really good player. I think, in general, across all of the Smash games, Mythic is probably the better player, but we'll see what we
Dude,
get out of
TTMP
this.
Dude, TTMP is sick.
He's, like, actually very legit.
He's sick. He's gonna win.
I kinda wish he played Melee, but, like,
nah,
you know, whatever.
It's okay.
PM Zelda is like good enough that it's actually really fun to watch.
Hey, what up? Okay. Wow. His up B just pushed him off.
Yeah, he's actually really nice. Smart about using his up B as a hitbox. I wish he knew how to cancel it better. Mm-hmm. It's a Zelda tech that's very important to the character.
Oh yeah, his winter semis, okay.
Nice. Just can't get these follow-ups that he needs. Roy's definitely got a different weight than the
Ooh.
Other sword boys. You can't really think of him the same way.
Damn. Logan just takes momentum right now.
Yeah, Mythic is not it's going to give TTMP the space he needs.
Oh my god. Oh, okay. Oh. Wow. Whoa.
Oh my god.
He caught the SDI onto the right side of the stage, and then he just destroys him. Charged forward smash. Sounds like he's very, very experienced doing this kind of combo setup.
Yeah, he does a lot of practice.
He has a lot of setups.
Yeah.
Which is crucial for Zelda, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, takes another stock.
I mean, you can kind of see here why the matchup is definitely favored for Roy. It's just so hard for Zelda to get in here.
Wow, that was just a really fast stock there.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can actually cancel the Zelda's neutral B by landing with it. So if you do a short hop and then neutral B, it like cancels the last like 20 frames.
Mm. Wow.
Which is...
That's nice.
Yeah.
Ooh. Wow, he's already at 76%. I don't think he's... This is looking very hard.
Yeah, this match kind of looks over to me, honestly, but...
Wow, just very nice down smash.
And that is a clean first game for Captain Mythic. Let's see if TTMP can come back from this.
He needs answers. That sounds cliche, but... He really does need an answer to this.
He needs something new, yeah.
Maybe a stage counter pick will maybe help.
I mean, where do you want to take a Roy here? Yeah, I would have said, yeah.
It's big enough. FD's pretty big.
That's not a bad decision. I mean, taking the platforms away from Roy is definitely helpful. Of course, that also hurts Zelda just as much.
Wow. Great reaction tech chase there.
That was a down tilt with a finish side. Further.
Wow, he just let him into the fire and then he doesn't neutral B. That's a cool combo.
Yeah, he does a really good job at making combos out of his dense fire.
Wow. I think if he just held a little longer to his forward smash, he would have gotten Captain Mythic.
Nice.
Oh my god. Wow, that was
almost
so
got the maximum hitbox off of dense fire. That would have been really cool. He's doing his up B a little bit too early, and it's causing a lot of problems for him here. The grounded neutral Bs are also not the best idea. I
stupid.
Disagree with that move.
I can't believe there's a chain grab in Zelda.
Zelda might actually
Zelda's
have a chain grab on
heavy,
Roy.
Right?
Zelda's not heavy. He's DIing shit.
Roy's also like spaghetti noodle sometimes.
Yeah.
His tipper is like really bad. Well, actually it might be good. His forto is so weird.
The like stabby thing?
Yeah, he did
yeah,
it again.
Yeah, it's just weird.
Mike Prime?
No.
No.
Oh, no, that's Logan's tag. He just stole Mike.
Logan's tag? Why?
Mike said he was going to come later, and then Chris forgot to put Logan in bracket.
That's hilarious.
So, yeah, we just figured whatever.
That's going to mess up the PR.
Now we'll remember.
I'm going to let Nate know. The PR master. Nathan Smelker. Ooh, it was getting close, but...
Yeah, you know, he's just gotta...
Good combo.
He's gotta find something to do with against these sword
Logan
players,
just has
you know?
so many, like... He's just adapted to these setups that Zelda has. Like, he's like, oh yeah, this is a bad setup, I'm just gonna play around it.
I mean, he's adapted to the setups, but TTMP isn't actually playing with Zelda's best setups. I think there's a lot to this character that he has left to explore. Which is really exciting.
Rip. Yep, it's gonna take it. 2-0.
Good set. 2-0 for Mythic. Hopefully the next time these two players meet, we can see something a lot more exciting, too. Honestly, it was, like, really interesting,
Scared
both games. I feel like both players had great potential there.
Scarce.
But, next up on stream, we have got Valkyrie versus Pablo is off stream.
John, what was the result of your match?
Dude's gotta report his sets.
Also, guys, report your sets when you finish.
It's gonna be yet another reminder to those of you who are actually bothering to watch this VOD. If you don't report your sets, you're an asshole. And everyone hates you. Did they literally finish a set, check to see who they were playing next without updating bracket and start that set?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Mike, you're playing on stream.
All right, next up on stream, we have got Mike Prime versus Skerzo. Now, Mike Prime is actually a pretty legit player.
Yeah, this is gonna be an interesting set.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what he can do here. It always seems like he's kind of on the edge of beating Skerzo, but he's not quite there. So.
Yeah, I think he's playing Luigi this tournament. Was he doing
so
that?
So it's not the week. This week is not the week.
I don't know, maybe. Luigi's weird. And Adrian's only good at the Fox Ditto. Shots fired. But, nah, I don't know. Adrian has had trouble with people.
Oh, he's not playing Luigi. He's playing Mr. L. Completely different character.
Wait, this isn't Death Note.
Oh, look, it's Mr. L.
This isn't Death Note.
Oh, my God. That's not what I'm going for. Okay, whatever.
I'm the meme master.
Just play your fucking character.
Meme master. That's my new tag. Captain Meme. Mythic Meme. Meme thick.
I'm just gonna put that in the next time you play on stream. I'm just gonna put in Captain Meme Thick.
Yeah.
Alright.
Back winners finals.
This is winter semis.
Well, I'll be playing in winter's finals. This is winter semis. Yeah.
Congratulations to Skerzo for taking this tournament.
What do you mean?
Wait, did Shay not put himself in?
Shay's not playing.
Why?
He said he had homework to do. I think this week is just rough for people. It's kind of hard to tell because I'm not taking classes.
Yeah, it seems like everyone is pretty stressed. Personally, I spent today talking about film. Because that's all I ever do now.
Like, I still have a lot of stuff to do, honestly, but my computer's broken, so I can't really do any of it. So I'm just choosing not to worry about it.
That's fair, honestly. No reason to stress over things you can't control. Oh, that was a cool Luigi combo.
Oh, what?
Ooh. Oh my God, what if he had gotten the edge guard off of that, that would have been sick.
Okay, I thought this Luigi was legit. Oh, whoa, what the? Dash turnaround up smash?
That was a back air. That was an easy back air.
Definitely. Ooh, I liked what he was going for there. A little too early. All right.
He's got some really interesting option picks, but I disagree with most of them.
I mean, he's still learning the character. But he's also doing some pretty cool stuff. Like, look at that.
That was interesting, yeah.
His platform movement has definitely improved, though.
Yeah, no, absolutely. He has improved so much as a player this year. It's actually been really incredible to watch.
I'm actually kind of excited for next year.
Oh, yeah?
If we can keep dedication for the club, we're going to have some really good players.
I mean, yeah. You've also got to get players who can actually, like, take games off of you.
Yeah, we'll get there.
Because you're just going to be dominating next year.
No, Che will keep me in line.
In PM. He's made it very clear he's not even going to try in melee anymore.
True. Although he was saying he might pick up Link as a main. His Link's not bad.
That was a clean three stock. It started out honestly looking a little even, and then Skerzo just said, "Nah, never mind.
I'm good."
Yeah, I guess he just got bored.
Who got bored?
Adrian.
No one's allowed to be bored in this game.
No one is allowed to be bored in this game.
All right, that settles it. Skerzo's DQ'd.
Yep. All right.
All right, let's shut the stream down. GG's, everyone.
Dash attack, 12 damage. Whoa, that crouch cancel was sick, honestly. All right. Oh. I disagree with that down smash. I think up tilt would have been the move there.
Yeah, up tilt would have continued the combo, and that's really what he needed to do.
Yeah. But he'll figure it out. He's been playing this character for, like, a week.
Yeah, it would be nice if he played it for another week.
Yeah. We'll as much as I dislike Luigi, we kind of need one here.
We just need something, man, honestly.
We do have decent character diversity. We have a Ganon.
We have a Ganon.
Yeah. I play Falco.
That's not, like, unique.
Falcos are a dying breed. PPMD's retired. He's never coming back.
Yeah, he is.
Honestly, oh, cool. I don't know. Maybe not, like...
PPMD's my favorite god, don't you dare.
No, PPMD's my favorite god, too, but I also feel like he's kind of, like, stuck in a thought loop at this point. Because he's been saying he'll be better in, like, a month for the last 6 months.
No, I actually agree with that. I think he needs to, like, actually make a commitment at some point.
Yeah. Like, honestly, I obviously can't speak for him because I'm not him, but I feel like he should try going to a tournament. Just...
Ooh, back to two stocks even. This is exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think part of it is, honestly, he's, like, pretty much better. He's just worried about underperforming when he comes back.
Yeah.
And he's worried that that's going to throw him into another loop.
Which is definitely fair. Like,
yeah.
We've all been there.
Absolutely. Like, disappointing your fans is always a bummer, but, like, people, I feel people understand in the
definitely.
Smash community.
Then again, you never know, because sometimes the Smash community is incredibly immature.
Yeah, but this is PPMB.
True.
If this were about Hungrybox, then everyone would literally just be telling him to kill himself, but like...
Or Armada.
Yeah. Ooh.
Oh.
Great job on that.
All right,
Let's
last stock.
Take this.
He's going to get up smashed. Adrian's... Yep. Okay.
Adrian's just like fishing an up smash. That's...
Well,
lame.
maybe he'll get gimped
lame.
For it.
Look at this fucker.
I like that.
Up air? No.
No.
No, he just wants the up smash.
No, he just wants to finish it with a hard read, honestly. I don't think he cares how it happens as long as it's a hard read. He was definitely reading that roll.
Oh, that was cool. Oh, no, bad dash attack. That was the wrong follow-up to that move. Oh, my God.
Oh, what?
The up smash. And now Skerzo is at kill percent. All right. Okay.
2-1 Skerzo. Or 2-0 Skerzo. Good games by Mike Prime, though.
2-1 Skerzo.
That game was bought. It was rigged.
It was rigged?
All part of the script, everyone.
Well, our streamrunner says that this game was rigged, so I guess we're just going to have to replay the whole set.
Honestly, I think we should just restart the tournament.
I just think we should just, like, DQ Adrian.
All right. I guess that's that.
Well, we still have matches going, so it looks like...
Are we doing winners' finals?
I don't think we should, because we're way too far behind in losers.
Mike
and
is here?
No.
No, I'm Mike. I didn't get entered.
Tonight, Captain Mythic is Miso on bracket.
This is going to go into the PR. Actually, I want it to, because Mike really doesn't want to be on the PMPR.
He doesn't.
So I'm just going to say that I'm Mike.
He does not like Project M.
Time to do my best Mike impression. Hey guys, Panopticon.
What? That's your best Mike impression?
John,
hey guys, Panopticon.
Hey, you want to go watch the Tonight Show?
Does he say that? Does
no.
he watch that?
Wait, which one's the one with John Oliver?
I don't know.
You said if you guys want to watch a movie, then I probably would. Believe.
Yeah, let's go smoke some weed and watch a movie.
You gotta watch that many movies. Every time I'm like, hey, let's watch a movie, he's like, nah.
Let's watch a movie. He's like, do you want to watch a movie?
Yeah, he invites...
It's like those quiet weekend nights.
He invites you to go to his movies, but he never wants to watch a movie with you.
Honestly?
Damn.
No, it's fine.
I mean, like, he's in the mood... When he's in the mood to watch a movie, he's in the mood to watch a movie, but, like, it's not like he's in the mood to watch a specific movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm always in the mood to watch, like, a very specific movie, so...
So I think that's the problem.
I will make him sit down and watch M.
Just make him watch My Neighbor Totoro.
M is such a good movie. It's... a movie by Fritz Lang that was released in 1931 that's about, like, Berlin and a serial killer and, like, the police are incompetent. Yeah. And it's Fritz Lang's first sound film. It's a really, really, really good movie. And it shows a lot of, like, the fears that existed in Berlin, like, before the rise of the Nazis.
Uh-huh. Before the wall?
What?
The rise of the Nazis.
The rise of the Nazis.
No, before or after the wall?
The wall?
Berlin Wall.
This was 1931, so that would be
Berlin
before.
Berlin Wall came after World War II.
Yeah, it was...
the Berlin Wall was a result of Russia dividing Berlin with the Western powers.
Yeah. So they basically split Europe in half, and then they also split Germany in half. What?
Can you open
that? Oh, yeah. Wasn't it...
They were supposed to split Germany into quarters, but Russia was like, wah, we lost so many more people than everyone else. We should get a larger section.
Also,
so Russia got like a third.
Also, it's Russia.
Yeah, pretty much.
Didn't they take the west side, though? West Germany? Like, wasn't it reversed or something? Okay.
They took the east. What you're thinking is Berlin was, like, just kind of stuck in the east by itself.
Oh, so the wall went straight through Berlin.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Here. All right. History lesson instead of Smash because we're waiting on bracket.
Hey
the only match we can play is me versus Adrian, and I don't think we should do that yet.
Oh, because all the losers are playing different?
All the losers. I'll tell Chris you called him that.
I want loser matches, loser sets.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Rude.
Yeah. So this is what
it
looks like.
Oh, okay. So it was just specifically Berlin that was split in half.
Yeah, and Berlin was split just the way that the rest of Germany is.
Gotcha.
So there were like three roads from West Germany into East Germany, and they literally just went directly into Berlin. And there was, like, no stoppage along it. And once you entered that road, they would, like, time you to make sure that you weren't making any detours.
Damn.
Yeah. It's actually, like, really, really crazy.
I thought they just shut the roads down. Wasn't that why we had the Berlin airlift?
There were...
Or,
like, I don't know how long it was or, like, how wide it was, but it was, like, mines and, like,
the
soldiers.
Wall. Okay, so the physical wall, which was actually two walls with, like, a no-man zone in between, was only in Berlin. And it was literally just a wall around West Berlin that had three checkpoints, Checkpoint Alpha, Checkpoint Bravo, and Checkpoint Charlie.
To make sure that no one tried to get into West Berlin, because then they would have been under European control.
Yeah, so Alpha and Bravo were the ones from West Berlin, like just kind of outwards towards West Germany. And the last checkpoint, which went from West Berlin into East Berlin, was called Checkpoint Charlie. And Checkpoint Charlie is where a lot of people tried to escape through.
Mm-hmm.
And there were just, like, ridiculous things. Like, a lot of people, like, hide East Germans and, like inside of cars. One person tried to, like, paraglide over. It was actually crazy. One family actually, this wasn't even in Berlin. One family that was just living in East Germany, like, stitched together a bunch of, like, cloth and built their own hot air balloon. Literally just off of a book that they read. They had no idea what they were doing.
That's incredible.
And they just, like, threw this all together.
East Germany, West Germany, what?
Yeah. We're talking about the division of Germany after World War II. All
right. What was your result? Dave.
What? West Germany was, like, democracy and capitalism, yay. East Germany was, like, communism.
What was your score?
2-1.
You won?
Yeah.
Nice. You're playing Mike Prime. Play on stream.
On stream.
Mike.
So we got Prown versus Mike Prime. We should just do this.
And then,
Mike Prime.
Once we finish losers quarters, we could probably go ahead and do winners.
Finals?
Yeah, once TTMP plays against the winner of that set, I'll go ahead and play Adrian.
Okay.
Or I'll wait until they finish so that we can play on stream.
So this is losers. Is round three?
Round three losers. Yeah, round three losers.
So Luigi versus Squirtle. I know literally nothing about this matchup. Luigi Squirtle, is that the matchup we're going to be seeing right now?
I don't know at all.
These are two slippery ass fuckers.
I think Luigi.
Random.
What's
on
up?
A random stage.
It's all right.
Oh, who's playing Zelda? Oh my god, you're doing it wrong.
Oh, there they are.
Don't down air.
I mean, like...
No, no! It's not your shield.
To be fair, Mike Prime, at least, has been getting better really quickly.
Yeah, I just know my Kirby's like way better than this.
We have our ups and downs.
It's also cold as fuck. I feel my hands.
Oh, yeah, they're about the same as mine. Actually...
Zelda is better.
Yeah, can you hand me my... the fluffy jacket?
You knew the character.
Thank you. Alright,
I honestly don't care about commentating the sets, since clearly they don't care about the sets themselves.
Same. So, instead, let's discuss... discussion topic.
Let's talk about the Panopticon.
All right. So, for those who are uninitiated, the Panopticon is essentially you are being watched, but you don't know who is watching you, and so therefore you cater to social norms because you think there's a chance someone is watching you, but you don't know whether or not there is.
Yeah.
The classic example is a prison in which there's a guard tower with tinted windows, and the prisoners never know if there's actually someone manning the tower or not. But they just have to assume that there is because they have no way of knowing. So, the Panopticon.
You know, it actually ties in a lot with Marxist theory.
It ties in with a lot of theories, honestly.
Yeah, Marxism was, I feel, one of the first theories to really talk about social norms and baby, what we're doing is just like a natural product that we logicked our way through. It was like something that our society created and then reproduces.
So, like, we reached a local maximum and then decided, all right, this is the top, and then gave up.
Kind of, except... It's sort of like we're still climbing the mountain. The way that Marx and Hegel sort of saw things is they recognize that society reproduces on itself. So that we're constantly in a position where, okay, we see how things are, and then the individual interacts with society, and that creates a new society, and then that society interacts with the individual, and that changes the individual, and so on and so forth.
Right, so society creates individuals which create society.
Exactly, it's a dialectic relationship. So a lot of Marxism is about recognizing that society itself is just like a product of.
All right. Therefore, communism.
No.
Oh, that read was actually sick.
Not exactly. For those of you who are Knox students and happen to be watching this set for whatever reason, I highly recommend taking Steve Cohn's Marxist Economics class. Very enlightening. He's actually a really good professor.
Maybe I should take that.
Yeah.
Because at this point, I'm basically graduated, so I just, I have like a year to do whatever I want.
You can do what I do, just do a film term.
That sounds like way too much papers.
It's actually really easy. You write like a page a week.
Oh. Maybe I should do that.
Yeah.
And just like be really lazy my senior year.
You get to write about films. It's pretty interesting. I watched a Soviet propaganda film today.
Ooh, that's always fun.
My intro class.
Was that the one with the steps and the baby?
Yes.
Nice. That's the one Soviet propaganda film I've seen.
That's the one that matters, really, when it comes down to it.
Who won the first game? Okay, cool. The score is 1-0.
I'm not going to update it. Fuck it.
All right, let's go, Leslie.
Can you click on one?
Gotcha.
Sorry, Bryce.
no.
You gotta ruin the fun.
How can I be kind of an asshole?
Wait, what? Why is that setup not up? Where's Che? Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure what's up with it. I'll go fix it.
So we've got the Hyrule Classic here. Ganon versus Link. I honestly don't even care. They're playing on random with random characters in random stages. I could not care less about this set. Do not think they could possibly have made me care less. I don't even know why I'm on the mic. I was just having a really nice chat with Logan about Marxism in the Panopticon. Dude, I gotta be honest, I had no idea what I was doing in that class today.
I kind of just wanted to participate today.
I made one comment, she was like, great comment, and I was like, sure, cool. Yeah, let me connect this to the one thing I know about. Sweet, I'm done. Pablo, we've got the ditto of the century. since I guess they're the same person. Spoiler alert. Both of these characters have a lot of good tools against each other, I believe. TTMP is starting off strong, though. It really does look like Pablo is a little bit lost on how to deal with a lot of TTMP's movement and his setups right now, but see how this goes.
Trey's here.
He's been here. Great job. Up smash. Forward air. Ooh. TTMP is trying to end this quick. He really likes to start out on smaller stages. His whole goal is just to fuck up the opponent and end this game. And that is clearly what he is doing here. 4-2. Let's go.
Welcome back. This is Wang on the mic.
We've got the one and only Matador Wang. It's all good.
Alright, so...
Alright, Pablo takes his first stock.
Who are we seeing? A Sheik?
What? Oh, might be. So we got...
The Sheik is just rolling too much.
That
but
is...
Good use of needles. Nice back air.
Yeah, how do you feel about Pablo Sheik? You were formerly a Sheik yourself, right?
Nah, that was some dark times, bro.
Some dark times?
Yeah, I didn't know how to play the game.
Fair enough.
Nice. It seems like they both like... reading charge attacks.
Yeah. That's definitely a style I feel that appeals to Zelda a little bit better than it does Sheik, though.
Which is clearly reflected.
Yeah.
In the matchup. But, you know, Sheik is faster, I believe.
Honestly, I feel like in the head-to-head matchup, Sheik probably wins as mm-hmm. well. I feel like Sheik can just do a better job at getting up in Zelda's business and mm-hmm. pissing her off. But TTMP is really holding his own here. He's doing a great job with his setups and just making sure that Pablo doesn't get the space to fill out combos like this.
Yeah, he's especially really good at disabling that aerial attack by Sheik.
Yeah.
Which is prime. Oh, card time killing him. Interesting.
Ooh, great job with the stop on that up B.
Oh,
and great read on the up smash. Holy shit.
Here, Pablo can end it. Here we go. Last stock, let's go. Comeback.
Last stock, yeah.
Oh.
Pablo, nice and I was saying this in an earlier set, Pablo is a very underrated player at this school, I feel.
True. Oh, that grab.
Up air, back air.
Slap it away.
The reverse hit, ooh, trying to grab. Keep this combo
there
going.
We go.
Another up air. This is anyone's game at this point. I cannot honestly. Believe he's made the comeback this far.
There we go.
Is that going to be
little
it?
Slap.
No, ooh. Great job with the hitbox. Oh my god, the slow get up. He doesn't read
a
it.
Slap. Nice. TTMP got back to stage, but oh.
And that is
Pablo takes the game.
For game one.
Let's go.
He's gotta work on his choke factor.
It's hype.
I got faith.
Alright, so where
fellow
do you
Zelda
think
man.
Pablo should take TTMP?
Oh, TTMP is picking here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. If I were him, I would want to go somewhere with a little bit... You know, initially, I would want to go for
short
somewhere
space.
With more space.
No, I would go to Wario.
But, you know, yeah, with his playstyle, I would go in somewhere where he can close down. I'd say Smashville or WarioWare would probably be his better options. Or Stadium.
I agree with you.
Yeah, I always like Stadium for Zelda.
Yeah.
I feel like the platforms actually just work really well for her.
I agree. the thing is that TTMP is going to do a great job staying underneath the platform and doing that
kind of shit. Oh my god! Holy shit! Holy shit!
You know what I'm saying? If he feels comfortable in this stage, it's game over, dude.
Yeah, dude. Holy shit! Did you just see that combo, though?
That coverage was amazing.
Yeah. That's the great thing about Dense Fire, is you can use it as your read.
Yeah.
You can use it to basically force the opponent into a situation that gives you a read, which
yeah.
is brilliant.
Now you use your needles to get out of there by Pablo.
It's definitely a necessary strategy, I believe.
Nice roll in, but nice read. And that's again what you're trying to say with the cover. He covers the whole inside of that.
Yeah. Just trying to read again with that up smash. Didn't quite get it that time. That was a good dash attack to get him off stage, though. Oh my god! And the side smash is to finish the stock. Pablo looking scared now.
Ooh, nice get up attack. Two of them.
You know, this is how the last game started too, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
So let's see what we got.
Oh, if only he kept chain grabbing.
Oh my goodness.
What coverage? Oh,
great job with that. Oh my goodness.
The grab by Sheik.
Trying to set up the combo, didn't quite get it in time there. Good call
TTMP.
Out with the jab. How is he going to finish this?
Oh! If only he read it to the right side.
Just missed it, right?
Yeah.
That was crazy.
Paolo seems to always be attracted by that fireball. You know what I'm saying?
Dude,
like, he's
you
like
know,
swerving towards
it. It comes right at you, I gotta be honest.
I believe you.
Oh.
Oh.
There's a side smash to finish out that second stock, or third stock, I guess. That is one left for Pablo now. Three stocks
go.
To one, TTMP.
Come back. Let's
it's go. 2-1 now.
Charging those needles.
Absolutely still Pablo's game. He's got to be able to make something
right
out
there,
of this,
that
though.
That grab was necessary. We need to see more grabs from Pablo. That's what we really need.
He got logged out. Why'd you play that off stream?
TTMP is just
doing
I'm
sure
a great
it was.
Job.
I would have loved
it's
to see it.
The sheep
damn it.
Just covering the stage. Oh, and a slip
and
by
Pablo.
Pablo
just threw that,
so,
unfortunately. 1-1, though. At least this is an exciting set. I'm looking forward to the resolution.
Yeah, let's see where we're. Pablo takes him there.
Yeah, for sure.
Interesting. I'll be surprised if they go to FD. Honestly.
Battlefield, always a neutral option. Good spot.
Again, maybe he should have gone to FD because TTMP does such a great job with the coverage.
Dude, he can do it even better. Without the platforms to get in the way.
I know, but...
Dude, that shit's just all over, trust me.
True.
FD is scary against Zelda.
I guess I was still thinking in terms of Mart. You know, like...
Yeah.
Like, one grab from Sheik, and that could be done deal.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice tilts, though. I know why he came here now.
Great read on that up smash again.
Ooh. TTMP is just all over there, shield.
He's doing such a good job with his reads on these charge smash attacks. Oh my god.
Nice use by Pablo to get back onto stage, honestly.
Yeah, honestly, just intentionally abusing and that dense fire out there. Yeah, he's been taunting a couple of times. I don't know if I agree with that.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think he means disrespect. Except on this one, honestly.
But it's like kind of one of those things that, like, why'd you taunt in the first place, man?
It was morality, bro.
You took a stock, dog. Like, it's...
Well, TTMP is a chill dude, but otherwise I would be smelling a money man.
Honestly, making these guys play another set or two, I would not mind watching.
Right. This has been so interesting.
Oh, great job forcing him off of ledge. Into an up smash read. Oh, my God.
Continues the combo.
If that had been the sweet spot, that would have been so hype.
Just released a little earlier.
Oh, there's a side smash. Is that going to finish the stock?
And the coverage. Oh, he gets him with the...
Gets him again with the up. Yeah.
Wow, Paolo is making this hard for TTMP.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Good side smash. How's he going to work this?
Going right horizontal through it.
Hell great read.
Again, the coverage. It seems like Paolo has gotten the hang of TTMP coverage.
He's definitely figuring out his option coverage a bit, yeah.
But he needs to do this, like, fast. He needs to get in there and do the damage. Like, it's great that he knows how to get around it now, but do you have time to get in there?
And TTMP is such an aggressive Zelda that he doesn't give you the time to think about
it. I know.
Yeah.
Could use some needles there, though.
Great sweet spot on that bear. And another one. Is that another stock? Oh! Just catches it above the side smash.
It almost seems like that's what TTMP wants you to do, to just go ham.
Oh, yeah.
So that he can go ham.
Yeah, exactly. He's saying, like, I dare you, motherfucker. Like.
Oh, my God. Nice
coverage. Like that dash attack, yeah. Oh.
And always able to.
Good reaction.
Oh, my God.
Is that not quite going to kill? Didn't get that up there.
Surprise, honestly. Wow.
And that's going to be Pablo's second to last tournament stock.
But let's go. Nice shield. Wait it out. That's what you want. Some nice, well thought out moves. Here we go.
I don't know if that described that down smash as thought out.
Well, the first three moves he pulled out were good.
TTMP's gotta learn platform heights. Up smash doesn't hit up there, man. Not on battlefield.
Funny.
Pablo offstage again, and that is it. TTMP takes the set 2-1.
Thank you guys for watching.
After a great first game for Pablo, TTMP gets the turnaround and ends the set 2-1. Could you update that 2-1 TTMP? Next up on stream, we have TTMP versus Mike Prime. Could you start that? Are you playing a character this time? Or do I just press random? I hate these guys so much. These assholes are doing it again. I refuse to commentate this.
Want to talk about the article?
Which article? The one we had to read for today or the one we have to read for Friday?
The one we had to read for today. I'm doing notes.
No, I honestly didn't even... I think
I'm
standing with these two. Yeah. I honestly didn't even finish that article. I like started reading it and it was like
the same thing over there.
Yeah, like all of her articles are honestly really lame and I don't really care about them. You expected it to be what?
A little bit more like feminist.
You should put the mic on. Yeah. I think. I thought she was going to go for a more feminist direction. I also was intentionally trying to lead it in a more Marxist direction because I know nothing about feminism.
Yeah, I know you're like pushing towards the whole like doesn't represent the group.
Yeah, I was trying to make it very clear that I had no idea what I was talking about. It was just kind of saying things. And then everyone was like, oh, that's a good point. I mean, I made one argument that I really actually believe, which is the whole, like, individual representing the whole thing that I was talking about. It's like, so in Marxism, there's a dialectical relationship between the individual and the society. And generally, when film represents that dialectical relationship, it tends to portray it as an individual that's clashing with the society. But what this film was, or like the individual, when it shows an individual, it's supposed to be like the individual is like the bourgeois that like doesn't belong in the society, whereas the society itself is like the workers. It's supposed to be like the people who are rising up, the people who you root for are the workers, it's the society. But in this film, they used an individual who represented a society, which, while it was interesting, conflicts with what Marxist film generally tries to do, or, well, more specifically, Soviet propaganda film, which Soviet propaganda film was very much focused on the group. Often in their films, they didn't even have a main character because it was literally just like, yeah, I'm not going to count that. No.
I see what you mean.
Yeah.
I'd also see what the past is.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that I had trouble with.
But you were just pointing it out. You weren't, like, advocating, like, oh, this is a problem.
Yeah, I wasn't saying that it was, like, problematic or anything. I was literally just saying, this is interesting. Are there other situations in Chinese film where they do things like this? Or do they tend to, like, as China becomes more communist, do they become more focused?
Yeah, you could have just asked that.
I mean, but there was no good way to word it. And so I was kind of just trying to start a discussion with it, and then everyone took my meaning wrong, and so I tried to reword it and just straight up asked her the question. She was like, oh, I get what you're trying to say now, and then she talked for, like, 15 minutes about it. So, yeah. She was talking for, like, a while about that question. She got way off topic, too. It was funny.
No. Today's discussion was pretty lame.
I feel like this week is going to be pretty lame, honestly. I'm not really looking forward to discussion on Friday, either. What? No. No. I wouldn't do that to her. It's especially frustrating coming to that class after intro film, where intro film is always this like really interesting discussion because the professor is like actually like a film professor and he like knows what he's talking about. And Mike will talk about Rob Smith a lot, but what he's really, really good at doing is when you have an idea, he'll like talk about it a bit with you. And then randomly, he'll just, like, throw you into a loop. And then just be like, you know, that's an interesting thought. And then he'll immediately ditch it and just start talking about something else. And so the entire... Yeah, but the entire discussion, that thought is, like, rooted in your brain. That you're, like, thinking about that still. But he's constantly just, like, coming up with all of these things and then just throwing them away immediately. But they're all really good thoughts. which means that when you have a class discussion with him, your thoughts behave the same way. That, like, he'll pick up your thought and, like, play around with it a little bit, and then he'll just drop it and move on to someone else.
Oh, okay, so he's, like, kind of, like, one-on-one with you.
Yeah. Like, constantly. But the thing is because he picks up and plays with your ideas the way he plays with his own ideas, your thoughts get rooted in everyone else's heads the way that his thoughts do as well. So you're... I don't know. It's a really interesting way of, like, getting a large group of people to all think about what each other are trying to say.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. It's, like, actually a really interesting discussion. You can just, like, yeah. I also kind of get the feeling, though, that he actually wants to say more to me than he can. Yeah, because, like, when I talk to him, I feel like he... No, this is game one. The last game was a friendly. It didn't count. Shit to TTMP taking game one. So, yeah. We'll see though. I still think that Dulasher is like a good teacher. She just like. She needs to figure out her class well enough to, like, understand, like, how we want to be doing discussions. I think that's part of the problem, is one day, preferably not on Friday, because we'll have nothing to say, she needs to just let the class go. And, like, the only things that she should be saying in class, because so far all she's doing in class is repeating what the reading says. What she needs to be doing in class is literally just leading people. And, like, when a train of thought is, like, trailing off, she needs to pick that up and connect it to another idea and then throw that out at the class and see what we do with it. That should literally be her only job. And she's trying way too hard right now to just lecture at us.
Yeah.
And expect us... Yeah. And we're just expected to respond by, like, asking questions about it, which isn't really a discussion. It can't start a discussion. If we're just like, what is film? I don't know.
Yeah, I got that same thing with, like, one of my English professors last term, where she was just lecturing, and where she wanted us to discuss, and I'm just like, this is
yeah.
How discussion works.
Yeah, come on, yeah. It's ridiculous.
No, well, like, I got a lot.
No, I totally get that. Would have to know the context.
Oh, it's like the tension between external.
So, like, the tension between, like, how she, like, appears physically and, like, how we interpret her emotions to be. Does that make sense? So, like, she's acting calm when, like, it's very clear that, like, she's not. Yo, the Zelda's fucking up this, Mr. L right now. That is it. TTMP takes the set 2-0. Is that still on or no?
Okay, what was the score?
It's 2-0. So next up, we got TTMP versus Captain Memethink.
Rob versus Roy.
Interesting. I wonder why not Zelda.
I don't know.
Problem with disjoints, maybe?
I don't know why he picked Rob instead of Zelda. I mean, I think Rob wins this matchup pretty solidly.
Uh-huh.
He's heavy. He's got a good crouch cancel options. All these rolls, man.
Red Factory.
What do you say?
Red Factory.
It's a Bread Factory, man. Hawaiian sweet rolls. Oh, try to call him out. Oh. All right, he's getting Logan.
Yeah, he is getting Logan.
Logan's actually really good at sharking out rolls. Because I roll a lot. So, let me take him all the way off. Ooh. Logan. Captain Memethink.
Interesting.
Nice okay. name.
That top might have actually helped him.
Who? Logan or?
Logan. Because it ended his hit stun. Because like, it had such a little hit stun. Yeah.
I didn't even see it. Wow, four stock. Oh no! 100% L cancel. He's maybe, on point.
Maybe back to. Yeah.
Yeah, I think the Zelda would be more
successful. I think that's good.
He's lacking in Zelda EXP, so let's see if he can catch Logan off guard.
I wonder why not down tilt.
Already on tilt. That's one thing Zelda's good at doing.
Tilting.
Yes.
Oh, very good at tilting.
It's like, why am I getting hit by all this?
Yeah.
This is stupid.
Just standing there.
Yeah. That's how she works, man.
Yeah, I know that feeling. I texted you about that last year.
Yeah. Oh, was this him?
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. I didn't know he'd been playing for that long.
Yeah.
TTMP's good.
He is.
All right, that one thing I noticed with him is that he does not like to grab. When's the last time you've seen TTMP get a grab?
No, he does not grab very often.
He does not grab. One of the best mix-ups with... Zelda has great grab follow-ups, too.
Ooh.
That was kind of sick.
Yeah, he's good at doing that. Putting the fireball on the...
Right. You read the roll? Yeah. One thing he'll do is put, like, the Nehru's... Or what is it called? The fireball behind Logan, and then he'll go in with a dash attack. And Logan's shielding. So, you know, here's the mix-up. Go in there and grab. Zelda fucks Roy up off of grab, too.
Yeah. Put the fireball a little too high.
Yeah. Ooh, good sweet spot. I did not know you could sweet spot from there.
Logan does like to go for the fourth hit of side B.
The what?
The fourth hit of side B.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, side B's so good when you know what you're doing with it. One thing TTMP doesn't do is if you you can land cancel Nehru's, so it's kind of like Falco lasers, like they just land and there's no lag.
That's pretty. That's
yeah,
pretty good.
It's incredible shield pressure, but it's hard to do. Double kicks.
Yeah.
Oh, good DI. Wow, I don't know what traded there.
I think it was Nehru's.
Good games from them. Not bad, not bad.
What is that? What is? Would you, what? Where is
yeah.
he at?
Am I in?
Let me see what spot you're at.
Fellows want to commentate with me? Anybody? Would you like to commentate?
Okay. Alright. This is basically like Melee, but not.
This is basically like
it's basically Melee.
That's exactly how he does it too.
Yeah. It looks really different on the game cam. It looks like something else.
Yeah, Logan looks a little iffy
yeah,
on the game cam.
We gotta keep it used for us.
His hands and his crotch
now
are blocked out.
Now that's a hand warmer.
He's warming more than his hands, bro.
More than his hands.
All right. I heard it was a close game. Didn't see it, but I heard it was a close game.
Did they have to
them.
Play in semis?
In winners. In winners
really?
Finals?
I
yes.
Was that not on stream?
Or maybe that was semis. Because Logan...
Or no.
No, Logan no, came in
finals.
At
was,
yeah, losers
it
finals.
It had to have been finals, right?
Yeah, because Logan didn't play anybody else.
Seeds, right?
These are our 1 and 2. Who's your money on? The PM player or Fox?
Logan's probably winning. But Adrian...
I mean, he lost the last game.
Did they play Adrian in turn?
Off.
What did he go... Oh, our game with Marth was actually... Oh, now I remember. Our game when he
yes.
played Marth was actually really close.
Yeah, I did see that Marth game.
And then he switched to Luigi and he beat me.
You've been playing good today. I remember watching that game. Ooh, caught the bad DI right off the bat.
Bad DI.
That's
or
the mix
it's just
the
that good.
With, like,
yeah.
When you're a Spacey and you're playing against Roy, The thing is, like, all his weak hits, you want to DI out so he can get out the combo. But at any moment after his first weak hit, he could just do an F smash because you're always in range for an F smash as a spacey. And if he catches the DI out with this F smash, you die right there.
Yeah, Logan's got that stuff, like, on deck all the time.
Yeah.
He just catches on to it so well. And both these guys just, they move at the speed of sound. Yeah. Of flight.
Ooh. That was a good shield stop grab.
Oh. Oh, no. I thought he was okay.
That poke, dude. That was a perfect angle.
That was
angle.
The cutest little...
Yeah.
Boop. Now, how do you... All right. you missed a tech.
Roy actually does pretty well against spaces in this game. It's actually probably an even matchup.
Just like Marth, if...
It is kind of like
worked out more and was shorter. He's way faster.
Oh, boy. Let's go.
That was close. That could have been a stock.
Okay, so the difference here might be that Logan's warm right now.
Yeah, he is warm.
He just played a game. So that might be, we're going to see maybe some adaptation from
This is a
Let me change the names.
Oh yeah.
Crap, how do you spell Skerzo? Is it
S-K? S-K-E-R-Z-O. Well, this is a best of three, right? Or is this Grands? This is Grands, right?
This is best of five.
So it's best of... All right, so Adrian's got time if he loses this game.
Mm-hmm.
It's not the end of the world. And a best of three if you lose the first game, it is not a good feeling.
In the best of five, you have you got room to play around.
Yeah,
though.
Game one is kind of a big deal, but
he's getting the sloppy salami right now, my man.
If I'm Adrian, I'm just gonna try and play patiently. Oh, okay, see, yeah.
Run up.
Just do what I do and just never approach. Just wait for the other person to mess up.
But he's Fox, though. Oh, that was almost like.
That's true, but you can still do that. Just laser.
Right, Fox
but
is probably
Adrian
the best.
Is not that kind of dude, I think.
Fox, the character with the best approaches, probably also has the best camping game.
That is actually super broken that he has both of those things. He can double laser. God, goodness gracious.
Three damage each. PM? Okay, but in PM, it's not a thing. Does not do three damage. It does, like, decays as over space.
Oh.
So, like, at the beginning, it's three damage. Is it?
Right?
I don't think so. Oh, did I miss something? Okay.
What I missed? Did he salt out?
He charged a neutral B. He went,
yeah.
Exploded.
And he killed him.
And he killed him.
Very dramatically.
And he killed him.
Well, he's got a lot of firepower.
Yep.
All of his moves are fire. A
lot of fire.
A lot of fire.
That's why you think that he's the better character when you play in melee. Like, this gun's got fire.
You hit somebody with up B and you're like,
yo.
That was like 25 damage. Like, are you serious?
This character's broken.
He's awesome.
Oh, he went for that. Did you say he went for that like 0% to catch the DI out? Kills himself.
It happens.
It does.
Too low.
All right. Looks like we got a focused Adrian.
He's not getting much off of these. He should just overwork, to be honest.
This could be big.
Sometimes it's better to just go for the guaranteed stuff and not try to gimp somebody.
Oh, that was almost sick. You're right, though.
Yeah.
Why?
Especially against a guy like this. Oh.
Where you might not get those chances again.
Exactly. You need that percentage. Even
he's
if
got
it's
it
not,
now.
Even if it's not, like, hype, like, you just need it. You need something.
Fourth hit. Fourth hit off the top. I didn't know that kills off the top.
That was a crazy angle.
Okay.
All right. That was
F-Smash is
like,
a sex
you can't be serious. He's doing this, and I don't take it seriously.
Yeah.
And then you get...
Even his
toes...
You get
the toenail. Yeah.
Even the toes were hurt boxes.
Oh. Ooh,
red. Didn't
like,
get
that
a ledge
dash. Like, that was the closest he's gotten to actually getting him a little.
The trick to edge guarding... I don't know if Adrian knows it. Wow, that was weird.
Yeah.
But the trick to edge...
What is the trick?
You just... refresh ledge invincibility, and he has to go on stage.
Yeah,
best case scenario for him.
It's like Sheik, right? You can just let him get on stage, and then you just mess him up when they get back.
Yep, do it again.
It's even worse than Sheik is.
That was a good.
Sheik is in the air for like 20 seconds.
Yeah, she's got no drift. He's got a little bit of drift.
Yeah, there's a little bit of drift.
But
Martin Roy, I don't have as much. Ooh, okay. There we go. This is good for Skerzo. Yeah.
Oh, dude. Like, he knows. Oh.
But he keeps, yeah.
I don't, well, it's kind of hard for. Try to get that last shine.
Guys, it seems like it's impossible to get a shine spike or something.
No, you can get one in this game. It's definitely. Do you know how the difference is in shine for this game?
I don't.
So
is it worse? Did they change shine to make it worse?
They did.
Okay, I really disagree with that.
Really?
Yes.
What
the
they
changes
did,
that they make in this game are they're very questionable in my opinion.
What they did was they took away invincibility on the first frame of shine. So it's no longer invincible.
In
this on the ground, the hit is the exact same, still on frame one, still unreactable, still leads to grab and whatever he wants. But in the air, it has growth now. So you can't get, on most characters, unless you're like playing another spacey, can't get a shine spike at zero. Usually they can try and recover one more time.
Interesting.
In the meantime, while I was explaining that.
Skerzo was shining more, and he won.
Yeah. There's a correlation between shine
I think
and
so.
Win.
Usually when I'm watching Fox and Melee, or there's a Fox Ditto, it's like, whoever shines more wins.
Yes.
It's kind of true. Oh, guys, is there a chain grab?
on Fox there definitely is.
Oh, no. Fox is good here, though. It's a double-edged sword.
Yeah.
Because he can just, don't get close to him.
Combo you, he can run away.
Do the Pablo and just don't get near him.
Do the Pablo.
Do the Pablo.
Do the Pablo.
Run away.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is not good.
Oh, wow, that tech chase. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, no.
That sucks.
Oh, no.
That
he got his
sucks.
Toes. He got his fingers.
He just misjudged it by a hair.
By a finger length.
By a finger length. Or a little pop.
So the other change, like I said, there's growth in the air.
Okay.
But so like at zero, it won't send you very far. But like when you're
I've
at
noticed.
90, it's better.
Okay.
So like it gets better as
it gets
the
better.
Percent goes up.
Shine.
Yes.
It gets better.
It gets better.
Even better than it already is. All right. Well, I mean.
And a lot of multi-shine techniques, things like that, are actually easier to pull off in this game. So it's. That's probably why they took away the invincibility and all that other stuff.
Oh, backwards.
And it also reflects projectiles.
Down here, okay.
Oh my gosh, what?
Oh no! It's the second time. Is it like...
Tell me that string wasn't about to be sick,
where
though.
It was going
to
fall and fast fell, I guess. Yeah.
Did that not look cool?
Reaction.
Slow walk forward.
Slow walk, yeah. Did he just... Oh.
These gimps, man.
He was like a 10% or something.
If you get an F smash on a spacey.
Yeah. Ooh, he did not up there, though.
At ledge. Done.
Oh, man.
Zero to death?
No.
Oh.
Oh, no. All right, just stay calm, man. Stay calm. Don't get out of there. No coaching, sorry.
I'm wondering if this is picking up your voice right now.
Is it?
I'm not sure. I hope so. You want to say something?
Saying something.
One more time?
I don't think it. Is it? Hello?
R.I.P.
Or is my voice?
I have no clue.
I'm plugged into this computer.
Oh, maybe that computer's recording this your sound? Maybe that's it. Okay, well.
I don't know. This setup is...
Okay.
Gotcha.
All right.
Yeah, this whole apparatus is...
This is a very complex setup.
Yes, this is very complicated.
There's layers.
Looks like a homemade time machine a little bit.
Oh, crap. Who won that game? Skerzo won one.
Me.
Did you win or lose?
Logan won. It's 2-1. It's 2-1. Yeah, it's 2-1.
The combo game on Fox in this game is ridiculous for
Arth
Roy.
Just has
It's like Roy. It's like Marth, but
or
I
Roy,
feel like it's better.
Yeah.
Oh, sometimes.
He's so good. I think I'm watching Marth.
Ah!
That sucks.
Ah, no!
Wow.
Oh, he went high. He went high.
That's, yeah. These edge guards are just... He's two for two.
Download complete, man?
Download complete.
B reversed. Oh, he got the growth.
Oh, is that the growth?
Yeah, he went super far. That's nice. Why he went so far.
Sexy, man.
He got the growth.
No wonder this game's illegal.
Yeah, dude. This is jank as hell.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. Plenty of time.
Ooh, okay. Yeah. But it's not too bad. This is
blip,
Fox.
Blip.
He can
blip, blip.
Blip, blip. Shine. It's a secret to everything.
Yes. When in doubt.
Shine.
Oh, baited. He baited that out.
Yeah,
well, oh,
bait.
No. He messed up the Firefox, though.
Oh, yeah, you can't afford to miss these techs on him. All right. Well, we're even.
Evened
Stevens
up.
In stocks. Oh, no.
This is so tense.
Oh, okay. But that wasn't bad.
These grabs that he's going for,
yeah.
After
good shine.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wow.
Quick gimp.
I guess that was technically
a gimp, but like
by default. But
yeah, he hit his head. A little bit of a mistake too.
Oh no! Get away! Oh, jeez, Louise.
Oh, I'm seeing Fox
Adrian,
stuff right now.
Adrian's so good when
the growth.
The growth.
The growth.
The growth.
All right, let's see what we got. Let's see what we got. Oh, the pummels.
Oh, no. Yeah, he pummeled just too long. Is he going to pay for it? Oh, okay. He's okay.
No Sakurai combo today.
Just laser, dude. Get out of there.
Sakurai combo is actually a lot harder in this game.
Yeah,
because,
that's what it looks like.
Because like, there's landing
stupid.
Lag.
Of course, yeah, they would want to fix that.
There's
of
a little
is
bit.
Like, so
there's
okay.
A little bit of landing lag
that's
on.
That's the pro up smash.
That was the pro.
That's the pro. Because it's like, did he see into the future and know? Because it's like a blink. It's like... I'm always so impressed when a player like a Fox does that.
The Sakurai? Or the
no.
The run-up up smash?
No, definitely not the Sakurai. No, just the run-up up smash.
Okay.
Because, I mean, it's not...
It's bold.
It's not committal. Like, not super committal. But it's still a risk.
It's like, I'm just going to go in there, and I'm going to hit you with the strongest move
the
I have.
The strongest move in the universe. It's so good. And we're on a
ooh.
Weird stage. Oh, no.
Okay, this stage is slightly bigger.
I hate this place.
Slightly bigger than Yoshi's, but it's got this platform layout that
yeah.
Allows for lots of weird platform movement.
Exactly, yeah. Which is why I don't like it.
In this game, because you can act out of tournament winner.
Oh!
Wow. You can actually, like... Yeah, you can
oh,
act
yeah,
way
right.
Earlier at a tournament winner in this game.
Yeah.
So a lot of characters can use,
ooh,
like, hack stats with it.
Is that down smash?
Yes, that was.
Huh.
That was the metal legs, my man.
The metal legs.
Oh. Oh,
great,
he went for that up
great
tilt.
Tech chest there.
How scared do you have to be as a fox
ooh.
Right by the ledge like that?
I know. Oh. That's a fox thing.
Yeah. Like, this stage is so small. If I get hit with anything, I'm dead.
Oh, yeah.
Why does he keep going high with that side?
Yeah. He's getting a little bit predictable with that. And you have a lot of time to react to it.
Wake up.
Oh,
wake up, blip, blip. He got
it's
up,
like,
neutral get up,
his,
and he just started
shining.
Wake
up alarm. Is just
yeah.
Blip.
So
oh,
risky,
no.
So risky.
That was risky.
It's tied up, by the way.
Yeah, it is.
It's tied up. This is the last. This stage
yeah,
really
this
favors
is,
Roy.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
This is a great counter pick.
But I think he's dead. Yeah, he's dead.
If
all
you ever
right,
go against
so
Logan, Logan, like, Roy loves small stages. It's kind of like
yeah,
Gannon.
That's what it looks like, because he's just fast and
if he gets
no
an
projectiles and
yeah.
He can just do all this weird combo stuff on platforms.
Gets an F smash at
oh,
40 and you're dead on the stage.
It's not over, man. Indeed.
Ooh.
Good tech.
Oh, what's this? Flubs?
Oh, no,
flubs?
No. All right. Is
took
that...
his jump. He took his jump.
Did he? Oh, but he's back.
He's bad.
This is dangerous. Gotta get center stage. crazy legs. But, oh.
Try to space the tilts.
It is so hard to make those techs sometimes.
6%? Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's gone.
This is not good. Oh. Oh.
Punish?
Excellent.
Wow. The flutter hush.
Okay. Oh no.
Oh, wow.
All right.
Last stock.
Will we see the reset?
98% on Adrian, though.
Will we see the reset?
Oh no. He's just going to crouch cancel.
He got the weak hit.
Oh no.
That's dead.
That's it.
All right, reset. Both of these guys are in losers now.
Oh, wait. Who was in losers?
Logan was.
Logan was in losers? Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
That is the reset. That's exciting. I thought that was the end. That's why I was so tense. Like, oh, man. This could be the end.
He lost in winner's finals.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Wait a minute. We have character changes.
Yes, we do. We're going to see the Marth.
Unexpected.
And this might push him over the edge because...
He outranges him, right?
Yeah.
He's way better.
He slightly outranges, and the spacing you want to be for a sword is maximum spacing, and that's where Marth's going to get that.
Roy has a... Tip envy.
Yeah, right. Tip envy. Never heard it put it that way.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
It's true.
He tried to fall through
Marth
that platform.
Marth is the bigger man. Oh, my God.
He doesn't look like a man. Marth is a beautiful lady,
actually.
Marth
is a beautiful person, whatever gender she identifies with.
Yes. Very androgynous.
Very, yeah.
Somewhere on that scale.
Well, both these boys are wearing capes, you know. Very in fashion. Yeah.
How are you guys hitting on this set? I'm commentating right now.
This is actually
I have lots of comments.
This is one of the greatest matchups I've ever seen.
This is actually a really interesting matchup.
No, it really is. It kind of reminds me of Fox Falco and that, like, they're equals but they're not.
Mm-hmm. Smells good, whatever.
Somebody's.
It is.
I don't know. That's just smell.
Ramen, perhaps?
No, it smells like bakery.
It's good.
It's popcorn.
it's definitely just popcorn,
actually. Yeah, he's dead. Yeah, this seems way better for Marth, actually.
Oh.
Oh, but.
Would someone like to commentate? Would anyone like to commentate?
Jay has to do a set, right? I don't know. Does Chris
want
to?
What is?
I like David. Where's David? Did David leave?
No nuts?
What?
No. Okay.
David and I are good co-commentators, I think. He might be playing Melee or something. But
hey,
anyway.
Can you find David for me?
Captain Mimic.
Can you get David for me?
He's kind of on the ropes here against this Marth. Oh, but that's a chance. And we got even stocks. Gets the grab.
Trying to find a replacement.
Ooh. Yeah, you got a DI out of that. Wow.
This is so close.
Yeah, this is actually very close right now. Is there... That felt way too... Is that guaranteed?
I looked away.
He just did back throw and... Forward smash.
Oh, that's definitely not guaranteed.
It's not guaranteed.
That must be a DI mix.
DI dependent.
Okay. What percent was he at? High? Or
it was at least over 60, I want to say.
Mid percents, the F throw and the back throw are DI mix ups. Try and get like a
because I don't
smash.
Know if Adrian like held.
He probably held in if he
probably
got
held
hit
in.
By the
yeah,
smash.
No, he got held in if he got hit by forward smash probably. Mm. Which you never want to be holding in.
I'm holding up bracket right now.
Yeah, you are. Dude, you can just go. I'll solo until
somebody tell somebody to come.
Alright. That's okay. Pleasure. But I will solo this until the love of my life shows up. And Chain makes everything for the better. But until then, oh, he tried to cheese him with that. Gets burned a little bit, but it's alright. He outranges with that.
F smash. Or as Bryce would say, a side smash. Yeah, Logan is really hard at low percents. This is able to poke out with the fire sword. Oh, wow, okay, chill poke. Oh, is he dead? Yeah, he's dead. That'll kill. Ooh, wait, is that... Wow, okay, so both of them just got pretty good gimps on each other.
Okay. Wow, it's close.
Yeah, it is. This has been a really... Oh, but we got a combo. The good old-fashioned Jedi... Oh, no, but he... SDs.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Good old. This is really, really close.
Jedi fight.
It almost kind of is.
Roy is Anakin and Martha is Obi-Wan. I think.
He's got the high ground.
Yeah, he's got you have the lower, you have the higher ground, Anakin.
He's got the high ground.
I just joined a prequel memes on subreddit. On Reddit.
Oh my gosh.
It's actually the greatest.
Prequel
the funniest
memes is hilarious.
Prequel memes are actually amazing.
It's so funny.
Heard of Darth Plagueis. Oh, wait, he's dead.
Oh!
Alright.
The double
dip. That was
dip.
Double dip.
Ties it up.
Skerzo lives on the edge.
Dare to dare. What is
dare
this?
Dare double.
It's character first.
Character first, right? Alright. We have some character stuff.
Alright, back to
wait
Fox.
Wait a minute. So Adrian is... Really?
I never switched off Fox.
Huh. Oh, dope. But it's 2-1 Adrian, right?
It is.
Or 2-0?
I think it's 1-1.
Or 1-1, sorry. This set is so good, I'm just in a daze.
Yeah.
These guys are
going back and forth.
Yeah, they really are. Different characters, different stages. It has it all.
Oh, he went for the dare spike.
Yeah. That was ballsy. Yeah.
Dare is so good.
Yeah, it really is. It's almost, it reminds me of Falco's dare for some reason.
It always sets up, like, if you get a ground
dare. It
sets
up something every time, almost, right?
You're always going to be able to pop. It goes
Jeez
straight up.
Louise. Oh, no. Is he too low?
The growth.
The growth. Did you see the growth?
Every time he gets shot at a ridiculous percentage,
yeah.
It goes flying.
I like that. I like growth. If they ever do, like, a melee remix or something, definitely add growth to it.
You definitely add growth.
It. Changes nothing
Ooh.
Else, though.
Oh, that slow walk. He's,
yeah.
He's creeping.
Just sneaking on him. Downtail looks like a really good option in neutral, actually.
Which character?
Foxes.
Foxes, yeah.
Because
nice
it pokes, yeah, it pokes a little bit. Oh, no! Is he all right, though?
Oh, he's fine. Oh,
he was okay. But
that was a sick wall tech to side B,
yeah.
But he grabbed
that
ledge.
Almost, wow.
They nerfed that. They nerfed
Did
the
they
up
actually,
smash.
Actually,
couldn't even tell, right? It's pout.
I kind of agree with that, but not really.
I mean, it used to kill every character Ooh. At like 80 for starting, or like 80, 90s.
This is a pretty Ooh. Great set of events for Adrian. It's got a solid 50, 65.
Now, Fox's up smash is the same strength as Ganon's up smash. So it's still ridiculous.
No, it's still powerful, but
yeah.
I feel like it should have killed before. Like, oh.
This stage has a ridiculously high ceiling, by the way.
Does it actually?
This stage has small size, super high ceiling.
I took a TTMP here because I thought it was... Well, I mean, I killed them off the sides, but like,
yeah.
It seems like the sides are not...
Sides are definitely small.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a freakishly high ceiling.
It's think like FOD, but bigger.
Sonic needs all that room to jump around, I guess, so.
I guess. I don't know what the hell Sonic does on this stage, man.
Yeah,
Sonic's
a
mystery.
This is a weird stage.
No one knows how Sonic works.
Up throw. Ooh.
Oh, Fox stuff.
I really like
the pummel.
Was that on purpose?
I'm not sure.
Sometimes
I
feel like you can keep people and then they know when they pummel out, they're going to fall off.
Release?
Yeah.
Release combos?
Release. Oh, man. This is critical.
Didn't get that re-grab. That's big.
Jeez, the side B keeps working out.
Oh, wow.
Almost. Next time is definitely...
Shine, turn around. The up B ledge.
Oh,
ooh,
no.
Wait. Is he okay, though?
Ah!
Oh. He should have went straight. He would have sweet spotted, I think.
I think so, but...
He went right into the hands of...
It's a hard situation.
Yeah, that was tough.
You have to be... Bye.
Later.
You have to turn into Einstein for a second and work out then. It's like that gif of Zach Galifianakis and all the numbers. Like, okay, 45 degrees is... Oh, man.
All right, so...
It's hard. Like, it's a great recovery, but...
Captain Meme Thick, poised to take the tournament.
Oh, I didn't even see the thick part. That's
Meme
also
Meme Thick.
I hope that's permanent.
Two C's.
I hope that's a permanent tag.
Me too.
Meme Thick.
He's thick, bro.
Wow. Oh, and he taunts. I always love that. But is he just going to kill him? Oh, jeez. If he keeps missing these techs. Dumb. Okay, he gets it there. Gets out. He says, do not get gimped, my man. I guess fair was a good option for that, but didn't quite work out. Oh, wow. That is such a good idea to do the up smash there. It'll last forever. Yeah.
I think they're calling me over there.
All right.
Let's see after this game.
Dash attack. Wow. It is taking forever to get this stock. Oh, jeez. Wow. All right, well, he finally gets it, but he's at a high percent. Ooh, but he handles it well. Yeah.
All right, we got a... Running long.
Just is back throw really? Yeah, I guess. I guess it would work. Yeah, these side Bs are actually a really good idea. It's pretty safe. Yeah, and it gets him centered ground so quickly.
It's the side B.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, if I get this, I have center stage.
Yeah, like right away.
Yeah.
It's like a cheat card.
As long as they don't call it out, I can get to center stage with this.
Yeah.
All right.
Ooh,
all
right.
Okay. All
right. Okay. All right. Okay, we're still going, man.
Oh, he
Skerzo's
almost had
combos
that.
Combos are just always a treat, man. I love them.
Sakurai!
Sakurai! Oh, we got the comeback taunt. Like, don't disrespect me, man.
That was sick, though.
Do you know me?
That was earned.
Can I borrow this? Oh, yeah, this is Kyle. Oh, see? Wow. It goes into a combo. Wow. Oh, man. Oh,
he
man.
SDI'd out of that
did he?
That up air.
Oh, wow. He's doing that a lot.
Adaptation? Oh my gosh. He's comboing the shit out of this Roy right now.
Oh, wow, but he gets all of the hits.
Oh, got him. All right, tied up.
Stock for both of these gentlemen.
Up throw, up air. Oh, but it's not.
In melee, that would have killed.
Nah, it's the same.
Oh,
get out of here.
Is it actually?
Yeah.
No, I actually don't know.
That was the same.
It was the same?
Yeah. Stage is the same, too.
Is this a game five?
Wow, we're getting 10 game grand finals.
I love these sets.
This is it.
All
right, guys.
Winner take all.
This is winner take all, right?
Game
here.
10. Well, this is actually, how many games have they played against each other total?
This
is something like 13.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, this is 15 games. Or no, 13 games.
13,
yeah.
Right? Yeah.
It's not best of five in winners. Okay.
Yeah, the saga.
Okay. These guys need to chill.
Ooh. Nobody chills when it's a game five. It's just
the best part about like long
just,
games.
I feel
like
people just throw like the kitchen, everything in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Like
the best
all the knives. Like,
it's It's because they played like so many games. Because
yeah,
once you get to, like,
it's like
game,
what's gonna work?
Yeah, once you get to game 10,
like,
you
all
know
my tricks are gone.
You know the punish
all
game.
All of the yeah.
You know the weight. You're like, all
it
right.
Literally,
I can get
just it comes down to who wants it more.
Yeah.
It's a matter of willpower.
Ooh. Blip blip.
Oh, that's
what are you doing? What are you doing with that?
Down smash was cool, but. This is what you gotta do as Fox. Just like, be like, I am the big man.
Take the free stuff.
Yeah.
If you can get one shine and then reset neutral, okay, I'm okay. I'm okay in neutral. I'm Fox.
Wow, up tilt.
Up air. Two up tilts.
Wow. Up a full stock now.
All right, all right. Let's see what the response is. The rebuttal?
Yeah. He has a chain grabbing opportunity here, right?
It's hard.
Like
it's hard at
second.
The beginning.
Well, yeah, it's low percent, so.
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness. That was almost a Skerzo SD. Would have been a classic one.
Oh, fucking double jab to shine.
Great
what?
Dash dance.
He's figuring out how to edgeguard,
yeah,
Roy. Have you noticed?
A little, yeah, I have caught on to it.
Ooh, dead.
Or he's just
dead?
Making it so much harder for him. Ooh, growth?
Yeah. Oh, no!
Growth saves the day.
Oh, punish!
Wait, what the fuck? Come on, man. After everything?
Okay.
Ooh.
Oh, it's too high percent to get the
hit,
follow-up.
Right?
He got the balloon. That's what's important.
Yeah.
No, there isn't. That
no, yeah,
that killed.
Is the only important thing.
There's no way that would have killed.
Go up, yeah.
Wow. Threaded the fucking needle. Oh, my gosh. Got it.
Oh.
All right.
Powerful.
Evened up. Two
yeah,
stocks left in this grand finals.
That was a pretty good stock.
Ooh, gets the burn.
But. Ooh, he just. All right.
This is the last two stocks of the set. I'm going to kind of finish it.
Yeah, it's almost over. It's almost over. Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, jeez.
Regrabs.
Oh. Takes on the platform.
Oh, the
wait.
SDI, dude.
Yeah,
that
was
crazy.
SDI. Fantastic. Oh, but he gets
rapid
all the
jabs.
Keep kicking.
All right, all
right,
like, all right.
I'm going to stay committed to the kicks.
Yo, low-key, Fox is, like, at death percent right now, though.
Oh, no, yeah, he always is.
That was an F smash. Did you see that?
I think
he
so.
Spot dodged, but that was an F smash.
Oh. Oh, no. Hairy situation right here. Oh. Oh, finally.
What's up with these side Bs, bro? What's up?
I know. They've been working out for the most part. Ooh, good
that
shine.
That was janky as fuck.
He waited. What in the world?
Down smash is, for both Roy and Marth, down smash
oh,
is like
man.
Super fast to come out. Like frame 7.
This is it.
Frame 5. I was corrected. Frame
5.
How was
he talking right now? What the fuck? It's the last stock of the... What the hell?
He corrected,
how can he talk?
He corrected me.
He corrected him at, in the middle of this.
Commentator.
That is the most badass thing I've seen today.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, my God. Is that how it's going to end? Oh.
Wow. I hate
crazy
to see it end
games.
Like that, but beautiful set.
I was rooting for my man, Captain Meme Thick. Good games.
Captain Meme Thick. Good games.
Yeah.